Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So of course I started out by showing you guys the wig and the lace. This is a 13x4 180 density wig from Ossilie Hair, and this video is going by really fast, so I have to speak fast. So I've started off by using the Shimmer Lights purple shampoo, and I just ended up pouring that in the water because it makes your blonde wigs or your 613 wigs less yellowy, and it'll get rid of that yellow undertone. And you can tell how the color removed or how the yellow undertones were gone because it looks very white compared to when I first showed the wig. And that first color I didn't show, but the first color I used was that platinum gray, or just platinum. Poured that into a bowl, did a test strand, liked how it looked, then I ended up dipping the entire wig in there. And when I do this, I usually dip it in and out just as I did with the purple shampoo. And before you ask, yes, I did this in my room, obviously. And yes, there was water on the floor, but I got the water up, so it's fine. And I don't have carpet, so it was fine to do it. I think at that moment, that's when I started mixing the Mystic Gray. Yeah, that's the Mystic Gray. Didn't show it, don't know why, but that's the Mystic Gray. So I know that it's all evenly distributed, and then I dipped it in and voila. So that's pretty much it for the dyeing process. Now let's get into the plucking. So I usually just comb my wigs out. I mean, I think everybody does this, but I comb my wigs out, then I put on the wig stand, make it, you know, line up somewhat or whatever. Just keep combing it out, and then I section the very front of the wig, okay? The very front. And then I start plucking backwards. I got these tweezers from BSW. I know some people use other special tweezers, but I use those from BSW, and they were like $6. But as I continue to pluck, I just section out the part behind it, if that makes sense. Like, I'll take out the front and then pluck behind that. And, like, I just keep repeating that process, and that's basically what you're seeing me do here. By the way, plucking and trying to get the perfect install is very, very, very time consuming, okay? So don't think you're gonna pluck for 10 minutes and you're gonna be good and your wig's gonna look nice, because it's not gonna happen. I promise you, this process, even though it looks like 2 minutes, it took me like a good hour or two to pluck it to my desire and what I want it to be like. So I do believe in this video. I don't know when it's gonna pop up, but I think I did end up, oh look, a zoom in, okay, but anyways, I think I did end up showing you guys like exactly how much hair that I plucked out, but even then I ended up going back in the wig yesterday, which was Tuesday. I recorded this on Monday. I did go back in and pluck the wig some more because I was not satisfied. But as you can see here, there's a big dramatic difference from when I first put that wig on that wig stand and from now. Like, you can definitely tell the difference. Like, it's a lot thinner, it's a lot natural looking, like, it just looks 10 times better. That's why plucking is really key to a nice install. And patience too. Like, you don't want to over pluck anything. Like, be patient. I did accidentally end up over pluck mine a little bit. Here I am hot combing it, but it's fine. Like, I can cover it up. It's fine. But there goes the hair that I was showing you guys that I plucked out. But I plucked out 5 times more of that hair than what I just showed you. And honestly, let's just get into the lace. Just taking piece by piece, hot comb and tweezers are your best friend in an install. I'm just hot combing it flat, just trying to make it flat or whatever. I just sectioned off the back, but I think I ended up covering that up because the part that I made was like ugly, so yeah. The wax stick is also important here. I did end up combing that edge back, so that's not what the wig looks like now. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the tutorial portion. Yeah. And now I'm back to show you guys the install process. So first I used that Wonder Wrap stuff, or whatever they call it, like protectant, to slick my edges back instead of using Got To Be. Then I'll put on a wig cap and spray Even Spray on it. Now I do want to say this before we get more into the video. So I did mess up this first install when I did it, so I ended up taking the wig off and redoing it again myself. But it's still the same process. So as you can see, I cut my ears out or whatever, and I'm spraying it again, and I'm gonna blow dry it just to make sure that everything's dry and make sure everything's intact. Next is makeup. I use 2 different makeups because your skin is not all one color. And I used that tint spray too. But when I reinstalled it, I didn't use the tint spray. I think that made it really light. So, yeah. Now, cutting your wig cap in a specific spot is the most important part. Well, applying the spray is important too, because you want to apply it like right before your hairline. This is where people lose their edges, like right before your hairline. And I have a low hairline, so that's why mine is like down so low. But now I'm just cutting away the cap, make sure I'm cutting on where I put the stuff. And now I'm using alcohol. I'm sorry, this is probably the worst voiceover ever. But yeah, cleaning the perimeter and just making sure there's no oil on my face because I do have oily skin. Now, this is where I put the tint spray in the wig too, and I'm also going to put the makeup on the wig that I had on that brush, and then I think I'm going to try the wig on just to make sure it fits and the color was right. There I am trying the wig on just to make sure it's all lined up. Now with colored hair, I realized that you have to put the hairline way in front of the cap. Because the first time I did this, I messed it up really bad. And you could definitely see the cap through it, which is why I had to take this install off and do it again off camera. So as you can definitely tell, the wig cap was giving me trouble And that's part of the reason why my first install was really ugly, because of the wig cap. So I ended up using a thinner wig cap and not that kind of wig cap. And then here I am just applying that Bold Hold Active. I did 3 layers of this, and then I spread it out, and then I let it air dry, because I like to keep my wigs on for at least like a week or two, and I don't even know what hairstyle I'm about to get after this, so I'm gonna need it to stay on for a little longer. And then here I am just cutting out the edge pieces. Well, not edge pieces, the parts of my ears, okay, the ear tabs, so I can have an ear. I mean, obviously I'm gonna have it. Okay, you know what I mean though. Just cut off the part so it's not blocking off your ear, okay? And when I bring the lace into the glue, that's why you guys see me keep using that pink comb, because I'm combing it into the glue. But like I said, the beginning, or like the front of the wig, where I put the part, I should have brought up a lot higher. Now in a wig install, that elastic band is going to be your best friend. Elastic band, tweezers, scissors, wax spray, wax stick, hot comb, all of that, rat tail comb, all of that is your best friend. But definitely that elastic band if you really want a melted lace. So I've never done this before, but I don't know, I feel like Wonder Woman today. So I ended up sewing my wig on in the back. Usually I just let it, you know, hang or whatever, but I actually sewed it in the back this time. Didn't know what I was doing, but I know it's secured and I know it's not coming off my head, so that's good enough, to be honest. And then here I am just making the part. The part actually is kind of straight. It's actually really straight, to be honest. And yeah, taking that elastic band off definitely hurt. You seen that face? Yeah, I know I ate that and saw love. But I really did it though, because like I said, I had to take it off and redo it. But, you know. I don't feel the need to keep saying, here's the hot comb, because y'all obviously see that it's the hot comb. And I use the hot comb majority of this install because, like I said, it's important to the install. Thank you. Now, at this moment, yes, you can see a little bit of the lace. But let me say this. Lace is fabric, okay? You're going to see lace regardless. So stop thinking that you're going to see skin. But anyways, I'm spraying that Eben hairspray on the lace. And then I'm going to use that melt band or elastic band again to melt it. Because that's, you know, it's a melt band. So... honestly, I wouldn't recommend that heat protectant spray. It's actually kind of trash, but that's the only heat protectant spray I had, so I used it. I would buy bio silk, but it ain't it's like $20 for a little bottle. Yeah, I'll pass. Then here I am thinking I ate it up. Obviously, y'all can't tell on camera that it looked bad, but like it did. But it doesn't look bad on camera, so I'm gonna just let y'all think that it was, you know, it was that girl. But it really wasn't that girl in real life. So I hot comb the baby hairs that I sectioned out, and then I'm gonna end up using a razor to cut them. I don't like to use scissors. I like for mine to have like that short to long kind of, you know what I mean. Well, if you don't know what I mean, you'll see. So I'm plucking out hair out of the baby hairs because one was mad thick and no, absolutely not. So yeah, I just plucked some extra hair out of that. So like I said again, it looked like I ate right here because on camera, like I said, it looked like it's eating, but in real life is what really matters, and it wasn't eating in real life. So, but yeah, there goes that shear that I was just telling y'all about, you know, just cutting the edges down or whatever, yada yada yada, nothing too special. Thank you. Then next, I went in with this mini flat iron that I bought from the beauty supply store. It was like $20, I think. So I curl upwards. I know some people curl downwards. I don't know what the difference really is, but I curl upwards and it gives them that fluffy look. I don't know, that the little fluffy edges, I don't know, that's like real cute right there. I don't know, but I use mousse and got to be spray. I use the got to be spray just to keep the top down, and then I use the mousse to like curl the edges in a C motion. So then after curling my edges, I just wrap them up with this black silk wrap. I think that's what it's called. It was like 99 cents at the beauty supply store. And then there I am showing you what it looked like after I installed it the second time. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.